Sometimes I do wonder how I end up in a wood drinking tea from a flask, or sitting in a field eating cheese and pickle sandwiches. Well, I've only got myself to blame. Hi, I'm Diane. There's a goal I've been wanting to do for a while. It's to walk the Nene Way, a walk that weaves in and out of many English villages and follows the length of the River Nene until it flows out into the sea. The walk goes through several counties in England in the UK and starts in Northamptonshire. I persuaded a friend to go with me, and I'm also inviting you to join us as we make our way along the Nene Way. I don't want to just walk the length of the Nene Way. I want to record it in my sketchbook and potentially make some final pieces of artwork by the end of it. You'll be seeing my sketchbook as part of this video. What I discovered on this first leg of the walk from Badby to Weeden Beck is that the River Nene holds many mysteries, and here are but a few.
So what is this? SOV.
We found this marker by the side of the river and we wondered what SOV stands for. Is it a source of the river? And that leads on to my next question. How and where do rivers actually start?
So this is the start of the river, or one of the starts of the river.
We found this stream at the beginning of our walk, but I think the source of the river started several miles back. If you know the answer to any of these questions, please feel free to add a comment below. One of the other mysteries that occurred on this walk was when this happened. This did really startle us, and we wondered why a helicopter was flying around this field. Maybe it's for training purposes? Anyway, let's start at the beginning.
This is the entrance to Badby Woods.
We decided to start the walk in Badby Woods, which isn't part of the Nene Way, but we'd never been there before and wanted to see the bluebells that come out in May. The entrance to the woods is marked with this old arch.
Maybe we can't go through the arch. We'll have to go round it.
We entered the woods, but what we found was that there wasn't a bluebell in sight. There were a few around the edges, but not as many as I expected. The first drawing in my sketchbook ended up being Badby Woods and the arch. I used recycled materials to make my sketchbook and collaged them onto the page. And here's my version of the arch with a kind of purple looking paper to look like bluebells. I'm showing some of the drawings I did in this video, but I will be making a separate one showing the full process. So here we are at Badby Woods. I brought a flask of tea with me, so we had a celebratory cup of tea before we started on the first leg of our epic walk from Badby Woods to Weeden. The walk actually starts in the village and is signposted.
So this is the start of the river, or one of the starts of the river.
I don't think this is the source of the river. It actually starts a few miles further back on private land. If you decide to do this walk, you will see some streams that will lead into the main river a bit further down. This first leg of the walk goes from Badby to a place called Newnham. It's an idyllic walk, but you may find a few obstacles on the way, such as...
This is deep mud.
deep mud all the way up there.
Some mud if it's been raining, and a few bridges, gates and stiles to climb over. That being said, it's a fairly moderate walk and so far has been well signposted.
We're still on the right way, we haven't got lost. And here, look, we can see a river, or more of a rivulet. Yes, the stream's getting a bit bigger.
The small stream at the beginning got bigger and bigger the further down the hill we went.
Can you hear that?
Coming in through there.
I see what you mean. Like, I think it comes out through several holes and then flows into the main river.
They're like springs.
Yeah. So what is this? SOV. Looks like some kind of...
We were a bit puzzled by this signpost that said SOV a bit further down. I'm not really sure what that means. If anyone knows, let me know.
It's widening up now, isn't it?
Yeah, it looks more rivery.
Yeah, getting ready to be a river.
I'm learning about rivers from doing this walk.
As well as experiencing the lovely sounds of the river, it's lambing season and we got to see lots of really cute lambs.
You saying hello? Oh, isn't it sweet? Hello? Hello, you three. Hello? You stay with Mummy? Yeah.
And yes, I've got to add them to my journal.
We're at a crossroads. Oh, we're at Newnham. That's why I thought we were miles away. We're here. We're probably about halfway through the walk.
The next stop is the village of Newnham. And if you want to rest, you can take a break at the local pub.
So there's a sign pointing up through the village. I'm guessing we go up that way. It's this gorgeous tree.
It's all smell. It's what it's called new.
Because it's new, mainly, you know, new in the 16th old. Century.
Yeah. They should have called it ye olde.
Oh, these houses around the green are gorgeous.
Oh, lovely. The Roma
arms. So you could stop in there for a drink if you wanted.
So cheers. On the way out of the village, we spotted one of these.
I remember the days when you could make a phone call in one of these.
A winter picture of it.
Oh, yeah.
And it turned out to be an old telephone box that had been converted into a little information centre about the village.
And then
there was a booklet inside that told you all about the village and its history.
Newnham at War. Oh, it's about evacuees from World War II.
The booklet contained lots of information about the history of the village.
Mary and Jean. They were evacuees.
As well as its history during World War II, when the village hosted evacuees from London. And this was another landmark to add to my journal. We continued up the village and noticed that there might be quite a famous resident.
Little hobbit house.
As expected, this is a very pretty village and gives the opportunity to have a little sing-song and maybe do a few sketches.
Oh wow, look at that. That is a lovely scene. In an English country garden.
I think we must have been feeling tired and had lost the plot at this point, but we were really enjoying ourselves and were ready for the next leg of the journey. In the meantime, here's what I added to my journal.
Now, which way do we go then?
Well, we don't want to go back up there, do we?
No. There's a church there.
Yeah, there's the church.
Oh, there's a sign here.
Yes. Did we go to the church?
Yeah, it looks like... Yeah, we do turn right somewhere, so maybe we go past this church.
The Nene Walk leaves the village by going past St Michael and All Angels, but we couldn't resist having a look inside. What we noticed about this church was that it still had all of its original pews.
So you'd have the number of your family box or whatever and then sit in it?
I think these pews were Victorian and it was a bit like going to a theatre where you'd have your own private box for the family. On leaving the church, the path takes you downhill through the churchyard.
Yeah, it looks like we're going downhill again. What is that? That looks like some kind, is it a mausoleum? I've never seen anything like that.
On reaching the end of the churchyard, we found this building and we weren't really sure what it was. But we had a good old snoop round and then continued on our walk. The walk allowed us to cooer over some more lovely cottages and then it was a case of going across some fields.
Look at that lovely cottage.
This was my favourite cute cottage of the walk, so that definitely had to go in the journal.
Nene Way is down there. Oh, look, look at that.
As we continued walking downhill, we could hear the water running underneath us.
Well, sounds like water's going down there.
And when we reached the bottom, we came across a place called the Nuttery.
I don't know why it's called the Nuttery. Maybe they... Has it got anything to do with nuts?
I found out later on that the Nuttery is in fact a hazelnut orchard, one of the few in the county. The next part of the walk involved climbing over a few stiles and going across several fields.
Yeah, it's all right. We're just walking through. We're just passing through.
Passing through.
Passing through, lady. Yes.
It's all right.
When you reach what looks like a sewage works on your right, there is no set footpath and you make your way across several fields, finding the stile at the other side to climb across or a gate to go through. And then eventually you'll reach the village of Everdon. Little Everdon is a small collection of houses and the walk takes you through the village and takes you through another field around the back of the houses for the last leg of our journey to Weeden.
We go through this because it said take a left on the map. Okay. Oh, look at that house. Oh, wow.
I think this building that we're walking behind the back of here is Everdon Hall. I only found out about it after the walk. And I think it has a lovely garden, but I'm not sure if it's open to the public. But we carried on walking along the next part of the route to Weeden. On leaving Everdon, we found a lovely idyllic spot to have our lunch. And then as we continued on our walk, we saw this. We've no idea why this helicopter was flying around this field near Weeden, but if you know the answer, then please let me know.
Hello. Hello, darling.
The last leg of the walk was across more fields and ending up in Weeden.
Do you find it relaxing?
Yeah, I do. If I stood here for much longer, I'd fall over and go to sleep. I love the sound of water.
We were intending to do some sketching and drawing during this walk, but we decided not to in the end in terms of keeping a time schedule, which is why I created the map-like sketchbook when I got home using photos and what I remember from the walk.
Weeden, yes, that's where we're going to end up, over here.
If you've made it this far in the video, please consider giving us a thumbs up and make a comment below. When we reached Weeden, we did notice some abandoned buildings by the side of the road, which looked really interesting, and they looked like they'd been empty for a long time. We then continued into the village and waited for the bus home.
Yeah, here it is, we're going home. Yeah.
Join us on our next leg of the walk as we walk from Weeden to Kislingbury.